Hey. We got MisterZimbu on the left versus Bohemico, who is a nose, on the right.
If you don't know, MisterZimbu representing a character called Bonus Coon from a fighting game. Is it from like Waku Waku 7 or something it's called? Maybe it's not from Waku Waku 7, maybe it's from something else. Anyways, it's a sandbag with a headband, which is pretty cool. Reminds me of the sandbag in Super Smash Bros.
Yeah, that's different. What I was thinking. What does the right one remind you of?
WarioWare.
Okay, fair enough. I can see it. There's the minigame where there's a lot of minigames in that.
Yeah, there's a game in WarioWare Twisted on the Game Boy Advance where you, you're like a finger and you're like, it's like a shmup and your whole goal is to like pick a nose at the very end.
Oh, yeah.
Like a 2 minute long shmup level where you're like,
it's kind of a throwback to the first WarioWare Mega Micro games where you have to put the finger in the nose and on third level it's both fingers. There's also the one in Touched where you have to make the nose sneeze by putting like a paper in it.
WarioWare Twisted, you know, is the one where it actually has like an accelerometer.
Yeah, I know. I played it on my Switch once.
So I played... Oh, that makes sense. I played it on... I tried to play it as a kid on a GameCube player. Because, you know, you play the Game Boy player that they made for the GameCube.
Yeah.
So you stick the WarioWare game. I was at a friend's house and I was holding the GameCube.
Oh, hell yeah.
I couldn't see the TV well. That was a lot of fun.
That's gaming.
I know. So it's given me a good gaming memory, but as far as these racers' records go, I guess, you know, they're about even. Mr. Zimbu has far more experience, though. Bohemico has actually been pretty involved the last year or so, doing all sorts of different stuff, but I think doing some weeklies as well, but has only been in MT, I think, one other time. Mr. Zimbu submitted Ball Cube, so.
Oh, Ball Cube, good
that's
game.
That's an awesome thing.
Yeah.
One of the greatest Mystery Tournament arcade games I've played, for sure. This next game, I'm completely blind to. I'm excited to see it.
Yeah, it doesn't sound familiar to me. When has that ever stopped me from saying things about it like I do?
I mean, you got that mystery brain. You're picking up on stuff fast.
Mystery brain. That's what my teachers used to say. I don't know what's going on in that brain of yours, Maurice.
what's going on in that boy's head? They would shake their finger. They would shake their finger in German.
Yeah.
It'd make different onomatopoeias. What's the most different onomatopoeia in German versus English?
I mean, that's a tough question.
I know. Most different is also unquantifiable. I gave you a very difficult question.
I can tell you that dogs go vow instead of woof.
Vow. Well, we have bow wow.
Yeah, it's kind of like that.
Yeah, what does a rooster say? Does a rooster crow?
A rooster
or say
says,
cock-a-doodle-doo?
Oh yeah, a rooster says kikeriki in German.
Kikeriki. That's just... Cock-a-doodle-doo is nothing, so I think that's fine. You beat us, for sure.
Yeah, they say kikiriki, which is funny. I never thought about it a lot, but that's a weird thing for them to say. Music is nice. I like the piano.
Yeah.
They should make more pianos.
Sometimes... See, I don't start with the... I don't have my collection of VTuber dubstep loaded up.
No?
So when I streamed yesterday, I just wanted to start with Rainwave, which normally is fine, but the first Rainwave song was, like, so, like, boring. It was, like, this solo piano. It was, like, not hype to start. And then the next Rainwave song was the same way, so I just had to start and just be like, well, this is what it is. But the next game, I believe, looking at the Steam page, hint, hint, although there's millions of games on Steam, well, it's not that big.
Everyone games. Will be able to guess which game it is now.
Yeah, like last year we played a game on Pokemon Mini, and I couldn't even really say what console was because there's like 10 games, so anyone could look.
It's probably the Togepi one.
I think that's
one.
Not quite the place. It was the Togepi one, yeah. This looks like a puzzle game.
It does look like a puzzle game. It has that classic puzzle game menu where there's like three buttons. We can take a look, I think. Let's have a look. It's called Time Ocean. We're gonna beat all the levels. We're Slime. We're Rimuru from...
Have you ever played Time Ball on the TurboGrafx-16?
I don't think so. But it sounds a little familiar.
It's a game where you like... There's like a ball moving around a track and you have to like switch tracks with each other so the ball doesn't like run into a wall. You have to like switch panels around to make it so, but it has one of the coolest covers of like any video game. And like you look at the gameplay and it's like very not reminiscent of what's on the cover, but the cover is awesome.
At Gamescom, I exhibit at the retro booth, and one time one of the people who also exhibited there had like a cabinet, like a display of all kinds of weird box arts, and one of them was also Phalanx. That's a great box art.
Oh, that's a good one, yeah.
This SNES shoot 'em up.
There's a great there's like a comic that somebody made that's like a story of like an old man playing a banjo, and then he like reminisces about like the time he was like in the military as a space shooter, and it like zooms out and like it's the story of Phalanx. Like someone made a comic to like make the old man actually be part of the story. It was pretty good. Unless you're not talking about the old man Phalanx cover. I assume you are.
Yeah, the old man.
Yeah. Salmon Buffalo says this game was fun. Shout out to Salmon Buffalo, new tester this year, been testing quite prolifically.
Alright, we're just fixing an issue on Bohemico's site. We see a lot of buffering. So we're gonna fix that, and then we're ready to go.
Google Cloud, is that like... AWS, but Google's version of it?
I mean, probably. Never heard of it, because they're not a big player, but yeah.
Every big company must just, like, have their, like, yeah, we should also sell some of our storage space. I mean, I guess it makes sense. You know, build this big facilities.
I mean, they make huge bank. If you look at Microsoft earnings, yeah. Then their Azure and live service stuff is, like, 80% or something. It's crazy.
That is insane. Oh, is this an X4? Honestly, like, I've never been that drawn to Mega Man X music compared to classic Mega Man music. But if this is X4, I'm into this.
This
I guess
is
because
X4,
that was, like,
yeah.
PlayStation. I like
Slash
that
Beast.
PlayStation MIDI instrument sound. I should listen to more of the soundtrack. I don't like SNES music that much, usually. I just feel like it's trying to sound too much like real instruments and doesn't do that good of a job. I prefer like high quality FM synth, like Genesis music over.
Genesis
synth
is
music.
Crazy. Everything sounds like it's wow 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 wow.
Sometimes you can do it well. Like we played that modern Misplaced, and that didn't sound like that.
I mean, you don't need to tell me that Sega can sound awesome. All of Sonic has awesome music from start to
That's
finish.
That's true. Well, how do you feel about Sonic Spinball music?
it's all right, actually.
Yeah, it's okay. It's very weird, but it's...
It's a lot more in this brown wow direction.
Yes.
Alright, let's see here. Bohemico's stream is not moving, but that's because the game is not focused. As long as we don't see the circle, we should be fine. But right now, I don't see a circle. No circles allowed. This is the Mystery Fun House, not the Mystery Fun Circle.
Vamos is Spanish or Italian?
I think it's Spanish.
I thought so.
Oh, Bohemico has left IRC.
Goodbye.
We're not quite there yet. Mr. Zumu's opponent has left. Now he gets a new opponent. I'm jumping in.
we just roll the we roll for games, but we don't make it clear. We roll for opponents too. We just kind of pull them out of a bag, and like Scrabble, you can throw away your tiles if you want and then pull out a new one. Yeah, I think a lot of there's also just like it was easier on the Genesis to make a cheapo game than it was on the SNES because you had to be licensing by Nintendo was harder. And just like Sega was like, please, we're new, give us games, make a game and put it on our platform, we're cool with it. And so there was just a lot of people who didn't really know what they're doing and made some weird wow wow Genesis games that just sound awful.
We got Moonwalker. That game has good music. Did a good job on that, on those songs.
I'm sure Michael insisted. He must have like. I know he was a gamer. You know, we know the stories. Michael Jackson was a Genesis gamer.
Yeah, he worked on Sonic 3.
And then I think he got pissed off that it sounded so awful, and then left the project. That's the most realistic speculation that I've heard is why Michael Jackson. Like, wasn't credited.
I mean, there was also the whole drama that started at the time. But what's starting is this race. It's America versus New Zealand. Do you think
this is
America?
This is a team demo, by the way.
Do you think America can come back?
I have a feeling this will be a particularly long race.
All right, oh,
I
no.
know this one. It's in Pokemon
Silver.
Oh,
no. Sokoban detected.
So true.
Oh, there's a replay. Wait, Miko Rock, watch the replay. Mr. Zimbu is also watching the replay.
Don't watch the replay. I do not recommend watching the replay.
Did you ever want to play a Sokoban game and at the end watch a replay of yourself? Oh, how do we solve this then? You can move to the past or future by operating the play bar at the bottom.
Oh, that's neat.
Oh, but you... Oh, okay, so it's more like a time warp. So when you move, your ghost also moves, I believe.
Yes. Well, because you're still going to the future. It's still happening. Until the time runs out and then your ghost doesn't exist anymore. How is Mr. Zimbu just getting here?
What do you mean?
I just feel like... How could he have already fallen so far behind?
Skill.
Perhaps.
It's just not a good day for North America.
Yeah.
Well,
USA. Well, wait a minute. Canada was doing just fine.
Yeah, it's USA.
Oh, I see. Oh, smart. Man, Bohemico got there fast. Oh, no, but it's not because you get telefragged by the box. You just have to wait one more cycle, yeah.
Okay. Oh, nice, yeah, you rewind one further. So that your ghost
then
has to move faster.
The
yeah. That's a cool
that's
solution.
A hole. I don't like that the holes look so different from the background. Because, like, that's also just an infinite hole.
Okay, so we're gonna do all levels, and it seems like we're halfway done at least.
I'm sure they get much more challenging, but yeah, it's true.
Oh, Bohemico went the wrong way.
Bohemico is cruising.
Bohemico?
What are you saying?
Bohemico.
I couldn't tell you.
Me neither.
Okay.
It's gonna kill Bohemico.
Oh! Right? No. He needed to rewind even one further, and then his ghost would have pushed it into the hole.
Oh, yeah. So two left? One more? Left? Go left! Yes! No! Well, I mean, that also... No. Oh, no. Don't restart.
No. I would draw it, but I think everybody gets it.
Oh, it didn't rewind far enough. No, go ahead and draw it. Idea, I'm not seeing enough movement. MisterZimbu, I solved it. MisterZimbu takes the lead.
Wahoo!
But Bohemico is right on his trail.
Right on the tail. This is, something goes wrong at another time, you'll get an alert.
But nothing went wrong, so Bohemico moves on to K, taking the lead back.
Well, I don't really understand what that means. I guess I didn't look at the pace bin at all. Maybe that would clear some things up.
But this is a race. I think you had to waste more time at the start. Oh, I think Bohemico immediately realized just up and down a few times. No. I think you have to waste a bit of time at the start. Unless you only have so many moves.
This game defaults to Korean, apparently, so Phone Noob is digging deep to find these submissions.
I guess you only have 10 moves in this stage, because the time only goes to 10.
Oh. Interesting. It wouldn't just extend out to 11?
Yeah, can't move anymore.
Got it.
Ah, missing one move.
This maze loop.
I think he had to move one step away. You've now moved to the right before rewinding. No. Because then his ghost won't be in the way. Maybe it doesn't matter if he didn't waste that move. MisterZimbu also joining Bohemico on K or whatever we're at. It's more like a T to me.
It's so obvious that the level's called Logistics Center. That gives such strong clues as to what you have to do to beat this level.
Literally, such so good, man. Okay, how far do we rewind? This is not gonna be enough in any case. I think we gotta rewind all the way. But this thing is in the way now.
You're not limited on how far you can rewind, I don't think.
Yeah, but your ghost is in the way and you can't push the box on top of it.
Got it.
Let's see if MisterZimbu is any closer. Let's do, like, this is almost forced, I feel like. Oh, that's a smart thought. Oh, and then move to the right. I think that would work. Maybe not. Because this thing's in the way now.
If he pushes down, is it a time paradox then? You can't, like, push into your ghost?
Oh, I think you just rewind all the way after what MisterZimbu did at the start. I think this level is way simpler than it looks.
That way you have time to get out of the way. I see what you're saying.
Yeah. I think this level is way simpler than it looks. So all the way now? All the way?
Since I know this game is on the shorter side, let's look at our testing times for this. Game's called Time Hole. What's it called?
It's called Time Ocean.
Pretty short. 22 minutes and 15 minutes, so...
I think this level is wasted. We just... Okay, hold on. I will draw. Watch me draw. Okay, slime number one moves up and to the left, pushes this block, and goes up.
Oh, Bohemico got it.
Oh, well then, screw me, I guess.
Well, still draw it, because I want to see what...
Well, maybe it's wrong. I wasn't looking. I don't want to look like an idiot now. think Mr. Zimbu just has to rewind all the way here. Just rewind all the way, and then move down to the finish.
Because the
other one will take like 5 steps here to even get there, right?
Yeah.
So I think that's enough time to get this box out of the way.
I'll go.
Well, not like that. Hello. There's a new chapter. This one goes all the way up to G or whatever it was. I'm not good with numbers. Counting letters is hard.
Oh.
Well, you can wait now. Or maybe you could always wait. Maybe this is like Outer Wilds. You just didn't know you could wait.
Or a less popular game that I can reference and sound smart. Toki Tori 2. There you go. So your ghost can't die? I say who cares? That's the other timeline. You don't need to worry about that anymore.
Oh, Mr. Zimbu has what I was thinking, and it works. Of course it does.
Oh.
Let's watch the replay, let's not.
Yeah, why does the Soka bot have a replay? It's especially funny to think about a replay in games like Super Soka bot that take like 10 years to do every level because it's just like a bunch of like really annoying moves. Why would you push it up? Okay, there we go. You're good, just get there.
Bohemico solves level. Hey, on to B. Okay, wait's here, I agree with that. Then pushes,
on the menu,
and now reverses all the way.
0 and 1.
Oh, Bohemico has this. This is solved.
Wow. Yeah, this nice job.
B solved.
Level B for big points, so true.
That was the big points level. Oh, Mr. Zimbu solving A. Still close race. Into the big points level now. Miko doesn't stop. It's already on D now. We got crumbling floors now.
Bohemico needs to...
Yeah,
well, this
just wait a bunch
difficult.
Here.
Why do you have to wait?
Otherwise it will be in the way when you try to push this box to the left.
Oh. He needs to wait a bunch even further back though, right? Because he's gonna run into his own ghost. Oh no, he just barely.
Yeah,
he got lucky there.
Perfect. Don't attribute to luck what can be explained with skill.
With pure skill. Yeah, I think that's how that saying goes.
Yeah, it is. Like the German version.
Yeah, as far as I know.
Oh, in this one you want to go down at the start. Like, wait a little here, like until 5 or something maybe. And then go all the way down as far as you can go. Because your ghost is gonna push this box for you. And then at the end of the replay you will move up again.
Waiting in puzzle games like this that are gonna then repeat your actions is like so
difficult
for me to
park. Like this, back up. And then push both of these boxes in. Your ghost is gonna come and push this box for you.
Got it.
Very nice. Oh no! One missing!
Oh.
Mr. Zimbu has a lot more trouble with this puzzle than Bohemico did. What has it now?
Like Tower of Principle 1 in Sokoban form. There we go, Mr. Zimbu beating level point.
Bohemico once again waited too long. So I guess you should just remember what number you were on. So Bohemico waited until 20 there. Oh, that's not enough. Oh, it is enough, just barely.
Wow.
Didn't even need to be that close. Still had two moves at the end, but I mean, not like it matters. On to level F. It looks very similar to the previous one. Just kind of rotated.
I have a feeling if you try and do the same strategy, you're not gonna...
I think in this one, your ghost will push one of the boxes instead.
Puzzle games like to do this, where they give you the same level twice in a row, but they like barely tweak something, and so you try and do the same thing, and then you're like, oh, I guess I'm dumb, I can't do the same thing. That's like a puzzle designer's favorite thing to do.
Enjoy this 5-second music loop.
I know this bass loop is like really, it's like I'm becoming one with this game. It's like affecting my mind. I'm in the time hole, which I know this game isn't called Time Hole, but I think it's funny that I thought it was.
I'm not sure what the idea for Bohemico's level is.
I have to say, this ocean with the sun rays and everything, for all I know, it's like a purchased asset, but
I know what the solution is. So the mistake Bohemico is making is he should be moving here, waiting here a bunch for like 20 or something, and then do this move. So he respawns here.
Oh.
And then I think you have to go left and right, right and left again. It doesn't work. Well, we'll see.
The game makes it red. Why does the game make it red?
The hole?
Yeah.
It warns you that your ghost will die in that turn. So like if it says like a 20 inside the red square, that means your ghost will die on step 20.
Man, I better not test any puzzle games tonight. I'm not in a good headspace for them. The drawing helps. I like the Madden.
Oh, the Madden is so good. Best idea I've ever had.
Well, I think once you were able to code cropping, I think you realized that you could code anything, because the live cropping of the stream seems so difficult to pull off. I'm very happy that you figured that out.
I just really hated doing it in OBS.
I agree, it's so much better on the dashboard.
I'm pretty sure about this move of respawning here. Like, that's the big difference that Bohemico doesn't say yet. I'm not quite sure where to go after that. But it's the kind of thing where you need to kind of see the state of the puzzle, right? Well, this can't be right, can it? The problem is, if your ghost never enters this area at the top, this part here, there is no way to get one of these boxes out without putting the other one in a corner or anything. So I think the ghost has to be involved in that part of the level.
Do 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 It's funny because it seems like it's about to resolve and then like something is gonna start, but it never does. It's like when people like make edited YouTube videos to only play the intro of a song that loops and like it like irritates you that it never starts.
Look at this graph. It is like something this guy made in like GarageBand on their Apple. Alright, Mr. Zimbu, how are we looking? This does not look good. Map, map. Oh, wait, we can switch audio. Lead audio. Oh, I was like, is the music different? But no.
Yeah, so Vitor, I think even we are a little surprised when we have to do GDQ streams, just how, like, they just don't quite have it together the same way we do.
Oh, Bohemico.
Oh, look at that. That was close.
Yeah. The ghost had been slower, but I don't know if it can be slower because maybe it had to walk across the crumble floor. I like that you can fast forward.
In this instance, JoJo the Oddish, I don't actually think it would bother the racers, but in general, I guess etiquette is you just wait until after the race ends to forfeit if you're still going to be around. Oh, if you didn't even join the race, then yeah, don't even worry about it.
I think Bohemico has an idea. Oh, we have parity. Mr. Zimbu joins Bohemico on F or whatever we're at. The F stands for respect.
Absolutely. RESPFFF.
Yeah. Okay, Bohemico has something. Didn't like it.
Oh, oh, there it is.
Oh,
oh no.
No.
How is this even possible then?
It looks so good. But maybe he wasted some moves somewhere. This is where I would actually like check my timeline to see if I was wasting moves anywhere. This should work. This guy just finished delivering the box at 18. That is enough moves if this works out. Doesn't like this black part. That's when the little slime will die.
You type dot enter or dot join, Maurice.
Join, of course.
Wait, Mr. Zimbu finished this level. What?
Whoa.
Now we need to rewind. Where's our time control at the bottom of the screen?
I was thinking of making it, and then I looked how hard it would be to make like an instant replay, and then I stopped. Because it's hard.
That would be so hard.
Also
that would give me I would be doing, I'm already having a hard time figuring out what I would draw. I would abuse the instant replay. I don't think you could trust us to make decent.
It's not a technical issue, it's a human issue.
yeah, it's a training issue.
But Mr. Zimbo on the last level of the goal.
I think so, yeah.
Carbon paste.
Yeah, it was
I think the solution Bohemico is doing is so much more complicated than whatever Mr. Zimbu must have done. Oh, Mr. Zim is not on the last stage. It's the penultimate stage.
Yeah, you know, this is a difficult game. This is just a hard game. Not a long game.
I'm glad I don't have to play this. I do not like... like, this was the worst puzzle element in Talos Principle.
Yeah, I'm happy that the new one doesn't have any...
Yeah. It's got like
oh,
kind
here's
of
the replay. Here's the instant replay. Okay, I do want to see it actually. Waits for a long time. Oh, and then waits for a long time in front of the second. Okay.
Oh, Bohemico missed his
turn. Yeah, that was a pretty fast call for Mr. Zimbu. So you don't actually come up. You wait in front of the first hole, and then you go and wait in front of the second hole. And then you back up. Yeah, the Escaper is a game that I highly recommend.
Never
please go onto Steam and play The Escaper so you can know who Holy is.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I do know Holy.
I should check back to see if that company has made any more games.
Right now we have a pretty close race.
So Hamako has moved on. No,
no.
Has left. The
has moved on to the same level.
Map. Yeah.
Mr. Zimbu doesn't seem to have an idea yet. He's putting moves on the board. No, of course not. I stopped trying.
Okay, I'm gonna now that I can't rely on Marines to solve all the puzzles, for me to say yeah, okay, I'll actually try and solve it.
Okay, go solve it. Mr. Zimbu is gonna die if he takes any step right now.
So I know you start. Oh no, that's the worst color. I know you start
just,
right.
Just
here.
Stick with yellow. That's what Alpha did too, and then we couldn't see anything. Yellow is really good.
It's good, but I don't. You're yellow. I'm pink, so people know who they have to blame.
Okay. Huh. I misspelled. I mean, you
15 misspelled. Is good for this. FBO is always like, oh, I'm dead. No! I'm dumb! Well, okay, fair enough.
Yeah, that's you. It's pink. Can't believe you managed to misspell dumb on your first try.
Isn't that just like so, it's like, it fits though, doesn't it?
Oh, I'm dumb. I'm bunt. Neither player really making progress. Zimbu has a good idea here, I think. Wasting more time at the start gives you more time to solve the second part of this puzzle. Okay, no reverse. This goes to the right. Now he's got 13. Like, can he just go up and reset from there? Why doesn't that work?
Oh, and finish before 13?
Wait, why is there no flag? Do we have to do something?
Flag is dead.
Flag is dead. But why do we not have a flag? Oh, there it
is. The flag must appear when you have anomalies.
Also, they have to survive. Okay, yeah, that explains why MisterZimbu can't just go up. Because you gotta fill both of these holes probably then in order to save your ghosts. Bohemico is still like engineering the most complicated solution known to man.
And I don't think it's even possible.
Oh, is this enough? Oh,
he's so far away.
No.
So let's start from the beginning here.
I think Mr. Zimbu has the right idea. Making his ghost push this block to the right, and then I think you want to be in the cubby. Right here. I still have your color. I think we kind of move like this. We reset here. And then on the next time, go here, so that after our ghost pushes the box to the right, and push it back to the left. And then maybe we just kind of do it for both sides, or maybe we don't even use the left side. Maybe this is bait.
And up here you just come up and then respawn, and then the thing pushes down, and then you're just at the end, like,
yeah,
you don't
exactly.
Even worry about it. Yeah, that could work. Or, I mean, it seems like it could. I'd like to try it. This is the kind of game where...
Yeah, you really gotta try it, I agree.
Yeah.
Like, I can think about this solution, and I think it looks good. But
there's a puzzle game that came out a couple years ago called The Golem. And the guy who made it said that he specifically wanted to design a puzzle game where you couldn't just try stuff and get the solution. Like, you had to fully understand it at the beginning, or else you weren't gonna be able to succeed. And that, I feel like that makes that game like 10 times harder.
Well, is it good though?
Oh, I think Bohemico has it.
Oh my god,
yes.
One step perfect.
On the final. This is something.
Oh, what I said obviously doesn't work. Because once we do this, there will not be a box here. We do have to use both sides, I think.
Yeah, because you can't even get over that. You can't push anything to the side without going to the other side.
So it's probably like something where we go like here to the left, and then we kind of do the same thing again, go up, and then push this thing down here.
Well, there's no reason to do this, right? Because you just...
There is, because we need to do this to push the box to the left. We need to push this box to the left.
I see.
And then this one comes down and is pushed to the right by another ghost. I think this is a really complicated solution that just kind of works out.
This is a longer level, by the way. This is, it says 30.
Looks like it.
Shoutouts to the Steam game Chrono Project, which also has a slider at the bottom.
Chrono Project.
I really... The full game is out. When that was initially sent to MT, it was just the demo.
Oh? Bohemico? I think this may be it. We went two steps.
They haven't resolved,
Yeah, but it's fine. It's gonna be resolved once you push a block down there. Right?
Well, but they're not.
Your ghost is gonna move to the left. And if you push the block down and in the way of the ghost, it's gonna save itself.
I will be right back.
Oh yeah, just rewind all the way, right? You could see this slime was walking here. If we rewound all the way, move this box first, then the slime would have pushed it. Okay, he's gonna try to save it himself. Has to kind of avoid his own ghosts. No. Oh! That's it! The comeback! It's real! Oh no, it's not! This is the last level! Ah! It's like the second time I thought we were one level further than we were. Can Bohemico walk into the flag? So I think Bohemico could have just walked like this and saved Paradox down there. Oh! All Paradox is resolved! On to the finish! And that's it, done! 35-42 for Bohemico. Wins this race in a kind of comeback, really. But really stuck on whatever letter of the alphabet it was, F, I think. But came back. MisterZimbu still stuck on G. The airplane level, which Bohemico reached after MisterZimbu did. Game has lost focus. It's a forfeit from MisterZimbu. Probably just not feeling it. There's extreme music suddenly. That was what actual music was like after 40 minutes of that.
I'm back. Who won?
Right player. Bohemico.
Wow, that's close. It was a close race.
Yeah, it really was.
Zimbu quit. Not surprised. Although, I'll remember Boom Ba-doo-doo for the rest of my life.
Boom Ba-doo-doo. Boom Ba-doo-doo. Boom Ba-doo-doo.
It really is like a 2 second loop.
Alright, doesn't seem like we're gonna get an interview. You just have to believe us that they're very happy.
Yes, one person won, one person lost, but they are both still in it.
The other was sent to the Shadow Realm, also known as the Back Nine.
Yeah, the Shadow Realm is... This is like an actual situation for Shadow Realm.
I can't direct them into the chat room. Discord, please. Ah.
Oh, neither can I.
It's over.
Okay.
Interviews are cancelled forever.
It's Jover.
Hold on. I'll restart Discord real quick. Technical issues. I mean, you can still hear me. Just ID is gone there. Who needs ID? Yeah, I guess Discord is dead. I shouldn't have left. No, we lost ID as well. Everyone is lost now. Only me is left. I'm sorry, everyone. That's all we got. Me. Little old me. Like, I would say, I'm gonna join their channel then. Yeah, no, I can't. I cannot because I'm alone in the server right now, according to my Discord. I'm already back in stream commentary. I'm not actually there. I'm like a ghost, like a time ocean ghost. We gotta resolve the paradox before the stream dies. Would be quite inconvenient. Ah, that's unfortunate. Like, I don't want to rob anyone the opportunity to come in and talk about the game, complain about the game. Maybe say a nice thing about the Sokoban game. Because this was pretty good. Like, as far as Sokoban games go, this was creative. It was different, it had a thing. Okay, I'm gonna restart Discord one last time. If this doesn't work, unfortunately, there will not be an interview. It's not looking good. Nope, I am alone. According to my Discord, I know I'm not actually alone. I see ID in the channel right there. On the stream. But I can't join. Okay, I'll try one more time. Fine, I'll try one more time. But only because you asked so nicely. It doesn't look good. There's no one in the channel, according to my Discord. Maybe I can try the web version, but I don't have the audio set up for the web version, so you won't be able to hear anything. I don't think this can be resolved right now. Unfortunately, no interview. We're just gonna ask them next time after the next race. Like, just remember, MisterZimbu and Bohemico, after they race their next game, we're gonna ask them, hey, remember that Sokoban game you played? What do you think about that game? And then they'll be like, no, I don't. Of course I don't remember the game I played 2 weeks ago. But yeah, that's the stream. Let's have a look what's coming up. Like I said, this was the last race for today. We're gonna... Oh man, look at this. A whole slew of matches. Tomorrow, starting at 1 p.m. We got Pond Noob versus Econ. 2 hours after that. So maybe we can play the Reject then. Remember those? El Cheeseboy versus Timo Star. Timo Star is my dark horse still. It's like... I see the same thing in Timo Star that I did in Someone 3-5. All those years ago. Back when I was young. It's a double! joined by Tapioca and Cabbage Hat. An hour after that, Half Beastie was chosen as Half Beastie! No, didn't. Just joined a lot of races. I thought maybe they played earlier today. Then we got Ellipsis Break vs. Mr. Moggy. Ellipsis Break also near, I believe. And I can tell you the match after that is on the next day. So this is literally all we have tomorrow. All of these five matches will be tomorrow, pretty much right after each other. There's a short break, but we can fill that. Figure it out. I've been Maurice. I'm still Maurice. This has been the Mystery Funhouse. And I hope you enjoyed. And you'll be back tomorrow in 17 hours for Pond Noob vs. Econ.